Hello everyone. I made that animation recently and I thought that maybe I would share some tips that might be useful for you as well. The first tip is in regards to what we call markers. So let's say you want to have an audio track in your animation and you want to center your animation around this audio. So what you would usually do is scrub through your audio and try to add keyframes while your audio is playing. A better way is to actually mark the spots in which you want to have your animation once in the beginning and then work in your timeline with markers. So let's say you have a beat drop here. You place your cursor in this position and then you press M to add a marker. And let's say you have another one here, M. So now that you have marked the spots where you have your change in tone or music or whatever, you can work without having to scrub through your audio again. This is very useful because markers can also allow you to do a lot of things using this menu, marker. You can jump between markers, you can bind a camera to a marker if you, let's say, have a multiple camera shot and you want to change your shots. Yeah, markers are very useful. Another good thing to know is if your scene is very heavy, so you have a lot of objects, let's say, and the viewport is really slow. Sometimes if you go to playback here in sync, by default, if I'm not mistaken, it's set to play every frame. So what will happen here, if your scene is heavy, your audio will lag behind your scene, your animation, your normal animation. So this will cause problems. What you want to do is put sync to audio. So this plays every frame. This here is kind of in the middle. So if the playback is slow, it will play every frame. It will drop frames. Otherwise, it will play every frame. But this one is the best for me because when you're making your animation, you don't care as much about visual fidelity as you do about making your actual animation. So you want to set this to sync to audio for better results. The second tip is about the 3D cursor. The 3D cursor is your friend and you should make use of it. By default, it's always in the world origin, but you can move it by pressing shift and then right clicking in where you want to place it. Okay, so I imported this piano model from Blender Kit and I wanted to simulate keystrokes. So if we select a key, you can see that the origin of the object is in the middle. So if I rotate it around the X axis, you can see that the top part is also moving up, which is something I don't want because this is not a proper keystroke. Okay, so the logical solution would be to move the origin of this key here. So if it's in this point, it will, when we constrain it along the X axis, it would move along this axis, which will be better. So the way to do this, which is actually easy, is using the 3D cursor. So we will go to our side view here and we will press shift, right click. So the cursor is placed here. As you can see, the cursor is placed on this side, but it doesn't matter because we will use the movement along the axis. So the axis that will be simulated is the one parallel to the X axis and going through the 3D cursor. So this time, when I move my keystroke, first of all, you need to change your pivot point. So before it was set to individual origins, you want now to change it to 3D cursor. So this time, when I move my key around the X axis, you can see that it's better. It simulates the keystroke a lot better. So now you can keyframe it as you like. If you don't have a TikTok attention span and you are still watching, it's good because this is the most important tip. So when you use the 3D cursor to keyframe your object, so let's say I will start here. I will press I, add rotation because this is naturally a rotation movement, right? And then I will move up a little bit and then move my object around the X axis of the 3D cursor, as we said, right? I, rotation. Okay, let's see what happens. You see this? Look, even in our first keyframe, our object is not well placed. Why? It's because when you set a keyframe, it's set depending on the origin of your object. But when you make a movement in regards to another thing that's different from your object origin, for example, the 3D cursor, it's not a simple rotation. It will become rotation and location. So what you do here is, hold on, let's go back. When you want to set a keyframe, even though it's a rotation movement, compared to the origin of your object, it actually rotation and translation. So you have to set it to location, rotation, move up, move it a little bit. Sorry, I, rotation and location. And now you see it's working properly. This is very important. When you do a movement around another axis that's different from your object origin, it should be location and rotation. The last tip is two shortcuts that will hopefully speed up your work. Let's say you have a long animation. Usually when you want to place your cursor on the keyframe, you're like struggling a little bit to place it, and then it's not quite there. You have to zoom in, right? And then scroll and then try to put it, right? A better way is just to select the keyframe you want to place your cursor on, and then press Control G. Control G. This is better. The second shortcut is when you want to move to side view, for instance. I usually use the gizmos, right? Some people use the numpads, 7, I think, 1. I think there is a better way. It's just using a pie menu, because with the numpad, sometimes I forget which one is which. So I use, if you go to preferences, add-ons, there's one called, interface, 3D, viewport, pie menus. You have to enable it. I disabled all the shortcuts aside from the last one, which is hotkey Alt-Q. This is the view numpad pie. So now when you press Alt-Q, you have this menu, right? And now it's better because it's also set. The layout is really well done. So you're right, left. And the good thing is you don't actually have to click on it, right? You can just Alt-Q and then drag and then release. So that, like this. I think it's really fast. That's it. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.